in, we needed Mayawati's support at the center.
So
we needed for all
her.
The reasons, but we went ahead because we realized there is a scam in 2003.
To politically corner her, to use the case against her politically. To say
know.
That if you move the other way, we will the Democles sword is on top of you and we'll let it drop.
But Arnab, you know, you're
Arnab,
just confirming what I said.
To answer also.
2000 and...
Can you allow me to answer?
He's going to say otherwise that I'm censoring him. Yes.
2003, the Taj Corridor and disproportionate asset case was filed by nobody but BJP. Somebody who had to pursue Mayawati and the case after 2004 February when the elections came is not BJP. It had to be the Congress government. So why do you put the blame on us? We did when she was our ally, and we went ahead because we said no, this is intolerable. There is a huge scam there, and the person who has traded off because. Congress also believes in a scam and corruption. They said there is a natural alibi and natural alibi.
Because there are a lot of people who believe that investigations need to be genuine. They don't need to be for political one-upmanship either after election or before election.
Absolutely. That DA case against Mayawati, it's raked up and then shelved, raked up and shelved as has been over the last how many years now? Say 8 years. Every time the Congress needed her support in Parliament, they, they sort of shelved the case. And when they wanted to pressurize her, they raked
used
up the
case.
That's right. And that's been going on. It went on with Mulayam Singh Yadav as well through all these years. And this is my point, that all these cases that are filed, I have yet to see any of them being properly, genuinely investigated, brought to a conclusion, and somebody being
How will
punished.
Mayawati respond in your view to this?
Well, I think she's just going to sit tight and go on, you know, converting it into a political battle because, you know, it suits her. The more she, you know, the more she sort of positions herself as a victim, the better it is for her in the future.
No, do you think the argument will hold here, Mr. Bhadauria? Please don't mind. But this park and all these statues, they were meant to be a symbol of Dalit pride. Right?
Now,
but now people say that even you did not even spare Dalit pride.
This is absurd.
This is injustice against people you call your own.
No. We had a Commonwealth Games celebration here in Delhi. And of course, there were cases of corruption. But that doesn't mean that the Commonwealth Games were put aside. The
are
game
you justifying
itself,
it?
No, I'm saying the game. I'm not talking of the corruption.
No, are you justifying the charges here?
No, what I'm saying... No, let me complete.
No, but
now, the Dalit pride, as far as that is concerned, the people of... Not only of UP, but the people of this entire country, hail Mayawati ji, because... It is the first time that two institutions have been built in this country which are dedicated to Baba Saheb Ambedkar, to Mahatma Phule, to Savitri Phule, to
It is very unfortunate that when we talk of a scam, you know, other scams are being discussed. I think any political leader and any national leader should take responsibility for the tenure that she's just been chief minister for. Speaking about Mayawati, we know that there is material to say that, public office has been misused, public funds have been misutilized. Why should we talk about other scams? If she has done her job properly and if she has discharged her functions properly, then let an investigation take place, a fair investigation by any agency. And
you have said, I bring you back, you have said 40,000 crore. Akhilesh has said 40,000 crore.
Right.
The annual budget of UP is what? 1.89 lakh crores.
Right.
So you are saying that more than one-fourth of the annual budget of the state has gone in scams. Right. I have a simple question for you tonight. Don't dodge this.
Right.
Show me one independent voice, independent agency which has come to this conclusion. One. B, give me the arithmetic which adds up to 40,000 crore.
Right.
You don't have the arithmetic, you don't have a direct link.
I would not dodge the question, but I'll tell you how the system works. You have to make assessments for the reason. I'm giving you an example. When RTI applications were filed in the BSP rule, no RTI application was ever answered. So there was no data to support it. Now the SP government is there. They're looking into those files.
On what
They're
basis finding, are you making a sweeping statement?
This is not a sweeping statement.
On what basis are you making a 40,000 crore statement?
That is the assessment
is
after seeing the files.
Hunting. This is political witch hunting. And let me tell you, a person who had 3 bigas of land today is the richest landlord Mulayam Singh Yadav, you come to Itawa, see his assets,
whatever statements he is making,
his assets
are not born out from the material.
He built an airport. He built an airport in Saifai on hundreds of acres of land for private use. What are you talking? You are living in a glass castle and you are throwing stones at others. Those people who live in glass castles do not throw stone at others.
One by one, I think that would make
no, but you can't justify it.
No, I'm not justifying. I'm saying the biggest corruption and scam happened during Mulayam Singh times, and let there be a total inquiry. Let there be a total inquiry from the Congress days till now.
Yes.
Let there be a total inquiry from the Congress days till now, and we will know. We'll pin down Mulayam Singh,
the Gundaraj
leader and the leader of the Jungle Raj, both Akhilesh and Mulayam Singh will be pinned down.
Is pending in the Supreme Court. And let me point out, in that matter, there was an irregularity that no prima facie finding was given by the Supreme Court. A review is pending. The matter is sub judice. He can talk about it. As a lawyer, I can't talk about it. And the figures that he's talking about, a Saifai airport, it is not anybody's personal property.
Of course, it is utilized for one family. Only Mulayam Singh and his family members use that airport. Give me one instance where others
he
are using that airport. Not only the airport. It is the lot of institutions have been built around for just one family. You are talking about 40,000
We came to discuss the statue now. Now we have made the discussion on competitive corruption. Whose corruption is greater?
Why should we talk about
the discussion was never about whose corruption is greater.
Isn't it sad that in all this, so much mind space taken up by your corruption, my corruption, somebody else's corruption, that what people are forgetting the real issue at stake. People of UP want development, progress. I mean, let's look at what Nitish Kumar has done in Bihar. When he became chief minister, I think he very wisely stayed away from, you know, opening up cases against Lalu and Rabri Devi. He concentrated on development of Bihar and is paying huge dividends. Today, Bihar posts the highest growth rate. Its plan expenditure is growing. There's economic activity,
which is what I'm saying today. Siddharth.
I wanted to add, you know, you're looking at how to add on 40,000 crores, and I think the Samajwadi Party spokesperson should have answered that. Just to give you a simple example, and I don't know how many crores it will add up to. There was a liquor mafia tax of 25 rupees under Mayawati regime on each alcohol bottle being sold. Now you can add how many bottles in 5 years must have gone and how many crores that may have added up together. So just for you to say that how does a 40,000 crore, there have been number of scams. There has been, you know, I can't imagine, there is a toilet scam also, which adds up to about 2,900 crore. That's what the media is saying. There are educational school scams. There are hospital scams. So you can add up. That's not an issue. I think the great issue
is that Mayawati has been synonymous with corruption.
And we need a proper investigation. But that investigation, unfortunately, if it becomes again a tool in the Congress hand, there is a problem because the center is weak. They will use it as and when they require to use it.
The real issue is farmer suicide. The real issue is they had promised free electricity to the farmers. The real issue is that they had promised that they will write off debts to the farmers. The real issue is the unemployment.
Those promises are being implemented.
So they want to divert.
Sir, the real issues are, that 150 farmhouses, 1 minute, of 10,000 square meter each.
Cancel all those.
But what about the scam? What about the money that has been paid?
One minute. The real issues are, since you provoked me to say this.
They are not the real issues.
You have seen the report this morning.
No, I'm sorry. I don't agree. These are the real issues.
So you can't silence me.
20
you can't
crores
silence.
Of
you
people
cannot,
live there.
Sir, you cannot.
You can't talk about you, 20. You tell me. You can 250 farmhouses.
Mr. Bhadauria, you know, I can compete with you on this because you will not be able to silence me. The fact of the matter, you cannot silence me from saying
the real issue. You are making your point, I am making my point.
Fine. So my
real
point
issue is different.
My point is that the real issue also is that 150 farmhouses of 10,000 square meter each allotted to 120 influential companies, 29 individuals at all throwaway prices. Tell me the cost.
Noida Authority.
Tell me the cost of.
It was not allotted by the Chief
Noida
Minister
Development Authority was under whom?
The Noida Authority, they will answer.
One minute. Noida Development Authority reports to whom?
Well, Whom? No, no, no. That is not the point. The point is this has been cancelled them.
Cancel them, but cancel. I mean, it's like Raja
what
saying.
What about the funds that have been taken by the political leaders for those allotments?
I think they have gone into Mulayam Singh's account.
I am not taking any
abroad.
Names because this is not about political rivalry.
Of course,
I think
why
if there
did
is
he go
a scam,
to Geneva?
There should be fair investigation, and if anybody is guilty, he should be booked as per law.
We'll follow the story. And Akhilesh should come on the News Hour and give us the breakup of the 40,000 crores. And but in the interest of transparency, we should have a debate on the News Hour between Akhilesh and Mayawati so we can do the mathematics of the 40,000 crores instead of a discussion on competitive corruption.
And will somebody in all this remember the people of UP?
And in all this, somebody remembers the people of UP. And the people of India and the economy of India, the crumbling economy of India at a time when Parliament, in the absence of any members of Parliament in attendance, as I'm going to show now, was busy discussing cartoons. And you know, this...
One point. And please bring me along with Mulayam Singh, whom I've spent 19 months in prison, and I'm being threatened today when I go to
Who's
Itawa.
Who's threatening you?
The people there. Oh. That your life is not safe now. That
if you wish to discuss,
that
you know, the political rivalry, I can discuss gentlemen, that all. The topic is different, so you should stick to the topic.
Gentlemen, Siddharth Nath Singh, Gaurav, thank you very much, Sudhindra Bhattacharya, Aarti, nice to see you.